Hello everybody, welcome to my sixth or seventh live stream. I'm Purple Mumbles, it's lovely to have you join me today. I see we've got Msaj, who's my long-suffering husband. He's chatting, or he's going to be doing my moderating for me today. And this is my poor son, Fluffy Cheeseburger. He goes online and streams also with some live gaming. Msaj is a live streamer of live music, a lot of homegrown stuff, as well as some cover sheets. So I'm quite new to the game here. Thank you for joining me. That was my son has just fixed up this wee wonderful mic for me, which I got as a lovely gift from my husband. So we're trialing it today and hopefully you guys can hear me okay. So can I get a thumbs up if you guys can hear me? Is this thing working? Can I get a thumbs up from somebody? That's wonderful, thanks. Thank you, hubby, I much appreciate that. So first things first for today, we're going to be cooking a vegan jackfruit curry recipe. I'm going to do a couple of little changes. You'll get to know that very rarely do I thoroughly do exactly as it says on the instructions. So before we get started, first we'll get our hands washed. Cleanliness is next to godliness, they say. I got a long way to go. I probably need to wash my hands just a little bit more. And you'll get to know that Purple Mumbles doesn't do her cooking unless she's got a drink with her. So I'll flick the kettle on here. It did boil just a wee while ago, but we'll give it another wash. And I'm hoping I'm not going to bug out this mic whilst I put my wonderful dear departed mum's pinny on. So here we go. So today's treat, we're having cool mint green tea. It's another one of the Pucker brands. Really love these teas. Quite delicious. If I can get it detached. Oh, the mic sounds good. That's good to hear. Thank you, son, for letting me know. I'm glad I don't have to shout because I thought that was what was going to be our problem today, is that you wouldn't hear me. We were doing a few test runs and I was having to shout over the other sound that we had going on here. Right, so what do we need to do today? First of all, on your recipe, you'll see it asks for 1 cup of raw cashews and soaked. So I've had mine soaking for a wee while here in a bowl of hot water. If you want to boil your kettle up now, if you're cooking along with me. No, I won't complain about the headset now. That thing kept falling off my head. It was driving me nuts. So yeah, if you're cooking along with me today, you need to get your kettle boiled right quick. If you haven't soaked your cashews, just take a cup of cashews, raw cashews. That's the unsalted, uncooked ones, just raw. Soak them in boiling water. So I'll just set these aside. We also need coconut cream, which I have here. Coconut cream, water. Handy dandy tap over the corner there. It's asking for 1 large onion. Now I'm going to use 1.5 onions, or 1 large one and a small onion today, because I'm going to be doing a little bit something different to this recipe. I have some tofu that I want to use up, so that's going to go into this as well. We need garlic powder. There we go. Ground ginger. Ground coriander. I'll put that in a sachet somewhere. There it is. Cumin seeds, or ground cumin, some garam masala, and some turmeric. And just for the easy side of it, we need some crushed tomatoes. I had some basil, as my husband would say, crushed tomatoes in my pantry that I need to use up. And you want a tin of young green jackfruit. This stuff is wonderful. It's kind of got the texture of chicken almost. You'll see when we open this tin up, when we get this stuff going. So a tin of green jackfruit and brine, and some basmati rice. Now they do say cook your own. Generally I would cook my own from scratch, but I had this in the pantry from a bargain box that I never got around to using, so I'll be using the microwavable stuff today. I shall do mine a little bit differently. I'm going to sling everything into one pan to save me any added dishes, because nobody likes dishes. So something a little different I'm going to be doing to this So I've got some garlic in my refrigerator, so some minced garlic. This gets used a lot in our house, so whilst the recipe's asking for garlic powder, I'll probably sling some of this into it as well. And I've also got some firm tofu which needs using. And the last time I made this recipe, number one son here, can I say you complained? Do you ever complain?
Never.
He complained that there wasn't enough texture in the meal. So I figured this time around, I'll sling a bit of tofu in there and it gives another layer of texture to it. So it's not gonna be pre-cooked, it's just gonna be cooked in with a dish. And at the end of the day, it's an added protein, so it goes a little bit further. So young son number one, has been my IT guy, and he's just mucked around and done something to the computer, which means absolutely nothing to me. What were you doing? Oh, he's done something to the camera autofocus.
It was going whoop whoop.
Oh, it was going whoop whoop. So it's now hopefully not going whoop whoop anymore. Yeah, I can't read and cook and do everything. I keep telling you. Right, so first things first, we're going to make our cashew cream. I've got a brilliant blitzer thing, this thing, my Ninja. But any of the smoothie machines or whatever will work just fine. Or even a regular old blender if you don't have a good decent juicer or blitzer. So let me just get that plugged in. And this recipe is asking us to make the cashew cream first. Soak your cashews in boiled water. That is done. Whoopsies, I've just made a mess on the bench top. I'll show you here is the perfect reason and display of why I put my recipe in a plastic pocket, because that recipe would be soaked by now because I just poured boiling water everywhere. So these have been soaking in boiling water. I'm gonna dump that water out because we don't need it anymore, but I'm gonna save this wee colander. I'll be using it shortly for draining my jackfruit. So, that's that cleaned up. Can you see how these cashews have swollen? I'll show you the size of a regular cashew before it's soaked. And this is where you really do need to get them soaked. You can do it for a couple of hours in cold water if you want, or do it within about 20 minutes in just boiling water. But look at the difference here. This is a regular cashew that's not soaked. And this is one that's been soaked. It's kind of squidgy in texture. It kind of bends a little bit, so it blitzes up really easily when you throw it into the food processor. And I shall eat that one that's not been soaked. Oh gosh, we're talking about nut sacks again. Yay, you can take that off there, Nightbot. Say that word one time and you never get to live it down, do you? Right, so soak your cashews for at least 20 minutes, which I've done that, or for a few hours in cold water if you prepare ahead of time. Drain the water and blend it with 3 tablespoons of cream, coconut cream, and 1/4 cup of water. So I've actually got 1.5 cups of cashews here because I'm adding the tofu. I want the sauce of this recipe to go a little bit further, so I've got a little bit more than I should have. So instead of 1/4 cup, I'm gonna add 1/4 cup measure and then 1/8 on top of that. I'll pop that into my blender first. So that sits on the bottom. So hopefully these won't get stuck. I'm not gonna say that these, okay, what are we saying here? No shoes are being worn. Don't wear shoes in my kitchen. Nightbot is a bad boy, yes. Right. I don't understand half of what's here. 9.9, you've appeared on my stream a few times, so that means you are officially one of those really good followers. And woo, hats off to 9.9. Let me just find my spatula, handy dandy spatula, AKA child briver or bowl scraper. Right, so let me put my cashews into my blender jar. So sit your colander aside because you're going to be using that later on for straining your coconut cream. Straining your jackfruit. And I need to open up my coconut cream, which is here. can opener. I thought I'd got all the tools out that I needed today, but obviously not. Not at all prepared today. Clean up the mess as you go along. So vegan jackfruit curry recipe. This is a really, really nice curry recipe. So as I've mentioned before, we've got our son on a vegan diet as recommended by his chiropractor. He's suffering or struggling to recover from 3 head injuries in a short space of time. So we're trying a vegan route in the hope that that's going to help him recover. So it says 3 tablespoons of coconut cream. So there's one. Second, and a third. And I'm going to put another 1.5 tablespoons in because, as I mentioned earlier, I'm doing a little bit more. I want a little bit more sauce since I'm slinging tofu in there as well. Use a hand can opener. Yeah, and kids nowadays, they're spoiled, aren't they, with all these pull tabs. I've got a pull tab on this can here. But like, what's a can opener? What's a record player? What's a CD? Right. So it's my coconut cream we've got inside of here. This is making the kind of the base for the curry. So the sauce that goes into the curry, and it's just the most delicious part. Right, when I put the blade for the top. Right, so we're gonna blend this. Now this is gonna get pretty noisy. I will turn my, actually, you know what, I'll leave my mic on for a wee second and then I'll switch it off. And I'd like to know if it was too loud or if it was okay for you guys to listen to. So I'll switch it on and I'll turn my mic off for just a couple of seconds after it's been running. Be good to hear how loud it is on you guys. Much of a killer for you. It's a killer here. Woo, it's noisy. Welcome aboard Lykonos, it's lovely to have you join us today. So we're making a vegan jackfruit curry recipe. The recipe is on my homepage. If I turn this mic back on, can you hear me again? You should be able to, yep, seems to be working on the screen over here. Yes, you see a line, that's my lovely mum's apron. I do love my mum's apron. So this is the cashew cream that's going to be the basis of our recipe. So I can move this out of the way now. Noisy old blender, but it works well. Yeah, it tastes delicious as well. It is just a really, really nice curry and vegan to boot. So excuse me whilst I have a slurp of my tea. All right. So that's our coconut cashew cream is set aside, made and set aside. And we're going to drain this tin of jackfruit away. No can opener required for this can. All right, I'm just going to do this over the sink because it may get messy. Righto, so this is jackfruit if you've never seen it before. And I've never seen jackfruit or heard of jackfruit in my life until I started cooking these vegan recipes for the family. And it's a really good source of protein and it has the texture of meat, really. Some people say you should take the seeds out of it. I say, why throw away something that you can eat? So I don't take the seeds out of it, I leave it in. But I will just pour this liquid off so it can continue to drain. without sitting in a bath full of liquid. Right, so we're going to shred this apart with our fingers. You can see here it's kind of, it just tears into pieces. You just don't want those big chunks in there, so you kind of want it like a simple fork size. Look at the seeds here. And they're good. They are very nutritious, so it's certainly, I would not throw them out. Go ahead and eat them. But you just don't want these big chunks in with your curry. So we'll break them down a little bit, but it has a texture similar, very, very similar to shredded chicken. And you can use a knife to do this or just tear it apart with your hands. Nut cream and, oh gosh, there goes my husband again. First dream funnies, yep, okay. Nut cream and jackfruit, okay. Yeah, no, husband has got a very dirty mind. He's been away from home for a wee while and I think it's starting to show. Time to come back for a conjugal, hey hun? Right, get those big chunks out and just put the little chunks in. So you just want to break it down. And after I've got this broken into here, I'm gonna sort my tofu out as well. I'm just wanting to, after 31 years, he hasn't corrupted me. You know, talking about 31 years, so we've just celebrated an anniversary. And 31 years is a long time. And for many of those years, my husband has said to me, no, I don't buy my wife flowers, because if I buy my wife flowers, she'll expect them all the time. So I basically never got flowers. And if I ask for them, if I say, oh, would you buy me some flowers, please? Oh, I was going to buy you some, but you spoilt the surprise now. So I think probably in the 31 years of marriage, for special occasions, and I'm not talking that I'm sorry, honey, I've screwed up, have some flowers, be nice to me now. In the 31 years of marriage, I think this is possibly the fifth time that he's bought me flowers on our anniversary. So once my hands are clean, I'll show you the flowers that he bought. They're really quite lovely. So yes, he did do good. And I got this lovely mic, which appears to be working quite well. How boring is it watching me shredding jackfruit? Sorry, guys. If you did it, flowers, F-L-O-W-E-R-S, yes, he didn't buy those kind. If he bought flowers, if he came home with a bag of flour, well, he wouldn't get in the door. Would you, hun? I remember many, many years ago, he would come home from work grumpy, and I wouldn't let him in the house, because I've had a bad day as well. Whole grain flours, all-purpose flour. Yeah, I've had a bad day at work as well, and he'd come home with just such a grouch, and I'm like, mate, I don't need to be dealing with this. And I'd say, you stand out there and you start singing, then I'll let you come in. So he doesn't come home in a grump now. Right, nearly there. So yeah, I mean, leave a few chunky bits here. You want something that you can get your teeth into. Is this a cooking stream or roast emsage string? Oh, you did the happy, happy joy joy. You remember, honey. It's been a while since you've had to sing that, isn't it? You learnt your lesson. No, this is not a rag on husband time. This is my husband has finally opened his eyes and seen the light and realised happy wife, happy life. And these flowers are just beautiful, and I can look at them and think of my darling husband. And I can even smell them, which is amazing, because I've got a really poor sense of smell, meaning I don't smell very much. I sound happy, happy joy. I can be trained. Oh, no. I don't know about trained, maybe tamed. I don't think I'll ever be able to train you. Right. Nearly there, last piece. I shall rinse my hands off and show you these gorgeous flowers. I brought them into the kitchen and sat them beside the stove because I wanted to make sure you all guys got to see how lucky I am. So let me rinse my hands off right quick before I touch that camera. Right, take a look at these. You can see them back there. Aren't they gorgeous? And I can smell them. They are just lovely. Look at that. Just absolutely bursting with colour. The roses up back here. And purple. So, from my name, you'll see I'm Purple Mumble. Love the colour purple. Oh, and there's purple on my dress today. Where's this? There's a surprise, isn't it? I should bring this back with me because I shall be needing that shortly. Right, now as I said earlier, I have some tofu that I need to use up. So I'm just going to split this bag open and pop half that aside as well. Look, I didn't cut my hand. Yay! I'm only going to use half of this because it's quite a thick block of tofu. And the other half I'm going to stick into a plastic container back into the refrigerator. And we'll have that in breadcrumbs tomorrow. Tofu in breadcrumbs, it's really quite delicious. So easy to do. I want to keep the liquid from that. Got to keep the tofu moist, guys. Right. As we go, I'm just rinsing out my containers. Everything that can be recycled will be recycled. Got to look after our planet here. So I'll just do my little bit. Right, and that can go into the refrigerator. Oopsies. Right, chop this tofu down. So again, just bite-sized pieces. So it's something to get your teeth into when it's time to eat. This is our dinner tonight, so I'm hoping it comes out okay. Always get an honest score from Fluffy Cheeseburger. Never do I score a 10. A 10 means that I have hit the absolute nail on the head, not just through flavour, but by quantity that I've placed upon his plate. So I never want to give him too much in case he doesn't like it and I end up throwing stuff away. So, I don't think I'll ever get a 10 out of 10, will I? So there's all of my protein. We've got tofu there, we've got jackfruit there, so lots of yummy goodness. And the tofu's are in a good sized chunk to popping onto your fork, to pop into your meal mouth when you're having your meal. Wipe this off. We'll be using that shortly for chopping our onions. Okay. Right. Drain the tin of jackfruit and use just your fingers to shred apart the pieces. And I stuck the tofu in there as well. So set aside. At this point, you should put on your rice. So if you guys are using regular loose rice, then go ahead and follow the instructions on your packet and get that started now. I'm going to be using a microwavable rice, which is not going to be microwaved. I'm just going to sling that into the pot when I'm ready to get things going. So not anything for me to worry about there. Heat a saucepan with a little bit of water or oil at medium heat and slice your onions. Now, I'm not going to heat my pan just yet because I've got a portable induction hob because I wanted to be able to do this underneath the camera for you guys. So what I will do is get my onions chopped, and then when we're ready to go, I'll just slide the induction underneath the camera so you can see what's going on. Let's get this outer layer of my onion off. So if you guys have got compost bins, then compost what you can. I don't have one because I suck at gardening, and unfortunately where we live we haven't got those wonderful compostable bins coming around to the house that we can stick all our leftovers into to be composted at a town level or a city level. So I hope you guys have all had a good week. We're now at the end of our week and last meal of the working week. It's been all go at my house. Right. Yo quit yo spam, you fool. Ah, Master Sergeant's talking too much. Capitate. You're trying to get your tofu moist. Yep, thank you, Independence Network. This is supposed to be a family-friendly stream, you know, guys. Right. So, I'll pop my onions into my pan as I'm slicing them. Move this into the shot so you can see what I'm up to. I mean, it doesn't need to be particularly small pieces. These are all going to cook down. Oh, my eyes have started watering. I should do this with a scuba mask on, shouldn't I? That'd stop the problem. How funny would that look on stream? This is a whopper of an onion. And my knife doesn't want to go through it. What a beauty. Skin off of that. Right, what plans have we got for the weekend, peeps? I plan to sit down and put my feet up. It's been a bit manic here this week. I've had tradesmen in and out of the house. And more to come, but the end result is fabulous, so I can't complain. One of the errands that I was going to have to get up early tomorrow to run, I was managed to tick it off my list early today, so I can have a little bit of a line in the morning. Boy, am I looking forward to that. Oh man, I'm going to have to get a tissue. Can't see what I'm doing. My eyes are running so much. Right, last bit of onion. I should have prepped these earlier, shouldn't I? So you guys wouldn't have to sit around waiting on me. If you could see my face right now. Glad the camera's pointing downwards. There's tears, man. It's making me sad. Oh, I hear the sound of a sun. Oh no, it's not. It's the wind blowing. We finally got a breezy day. Boy, it's lovely. Now all we need is some rain. It's been trying on and off throughout the day, but not a whole lot has happened really. I know, dull knife. Well, you know what, I'm sure I'm safe with the dull knife. Talk to my dad to tell me otherwise. But excuse me, I have to step aside. I'm going to mute you guys for a moment because I've got to blow my nose. Those onions have really got to me. I'll be back. Did you see the tear? Right, let me wash my hands off again. Okay, we got the onions in the pot. Says heat a saucepan. See, I'm not gonna do this the way that it's asking me to do it, I'm sure. Slice your onions and add them to the saucepan. A little bit of water or oil at medium heat. Well, I'm gonna use water. There's a bit of boiling water there. I'll just clear this out of the way and make a little bit of room underneath the camera, which I shall point down, and I'll set my lovely portable induction unit into place there. Right, can we all see that clearly? It's a beast of a machine, I tell you. Oh, and it's noisy too. Right, now I'm hoping this is going to work. I've never used this before, so there's a lot of guessing going on here. Oh, and I need a stirry. Maybe a nice red, bright spatula. Oh no, I'll use that spoon. I like that spoon. Perfect. Right, how do you turn this thing on? Is this thing on? Okay, something's happening. We've got fans running. Right, something's happening in there. Let's see if this starts bubbling. I'm not feeling any heat yet. Oh yes, I am. Man, that's quick. Holy moly, that's so fast. Right, cook your onions, Linda. Get cooking, come on. Be happening already. Maybe I should turn that up a little bit. Spoon rest so I don't make a huge mess all over my kitchen bench. Is the pan $5 to rub onion in your eyes? No, no way, ain't gonna happen. Yep, I put the onion in a pot. Oh look, and we're sizzling. So yes, the pan must be magnetic, otherwise it wouldn't be sizzling. It is quick. Man, there's some onion juice coming out here. Come to life, my pretty. Right, so, still on number three. Heat a saucepan with a little bit of water or oil at medium heat. Slice your onions and add them to the saucepan. Once they're starting to soften, add in all your spices and stir well. Add a little bit more water if it's sticking. So, I'm gonna sling my garlic in here now as well. So I'm going to be using powdered garlic and I'm going to be using fresh garlic. So I'm going to have probably, it's about 3 cloves of garlic, I guess, there. And then I'll stick to most of the recipe for the dried spices. Put that back in the fridge. Have I mentioned how much I love my kitchen? I love my kitchen. That's what really sold me when we came looking at this house. Husband was all about the outside space. He wanted somewhere that he could park a trailer or a boat or a caravan or something. For me, it was all about a usable kitchen. And that's what I got. Love my kitchen. So what is in the pan? Hi, Idrakini. I've got onions in the pan here and garlic and a little bit of water. I'm making a vegan jackfruit curry recipe. Thank you for joining us. The recipe is within my stream and also on my front page. Whew, those onions are really going into my eyes now. I'm gonna do it with an extractor above here. I might just flick mine on across the other side of the kitchen just to get the kitchen pongs out as much as we can. Well, yep, steam started going that way, which will be right in my face. So it's a jackfruit curry recipe, and I'm going to be popping tofu into this as well. We've already made the cashew cream sauce, so if you missed that part of the cooking show, then have a watch of the recording at the end. It will show you how to make that, or just print off the recipe and take it from the recipe. I'm doing my things a little bit different to the recipe, but so far we've got our jackfruit and tofu, because I'm adding tofu to this also. Already jackfruit is shredded and the tofu is sliced, ready to go. In the pan we've got onions and garlic cooking, and I've used some fresh garlic as well as onion. And now I'm going to be adding my spices. So the recipe calls for 1 teaspoon of garlic powder. Because I'm doing the tofu in here as well, I'm going to add half as much as the recipe requests again. This can be really garlicky because I put fresh garlic in here as well. That's okay. We all like garlic in this house, especially the sun. 1 teaspoon of ground ginger. My measure fit in there? Yes, it will. So there's one, and I should be adding a half as well. One teaspoon of coriander. Not cutting it open. What would you suggest if you can't get jackfruit? Honestly, just use tofu. Ahead of breadfruit. 1 1/2 of coriander. Yeah, I'd probably just go for tofu. I don't know what breadfruit is, M. Sarge, hubby. And if you can't get jackfruit, go into your supermarket and tell them they need to get it in. Because it's good stuff. No, I'd never heard of it before either, but I was really surprised when our little old supermarket in our little old town and little podink little old country where we live has jackfruit. So if we can get it here, I think you'll be surprised. You might be able to find it also. And it may be in the vegetarian section of your supermarket. Always worth asking. I think Tesco's does have it. So sorry, there's me just jumping in there with the English part of me. I'm pretty certain I was looking it up the other day to see if I could make this for dear old dad when I go to visit him. And I'm pretty certain you can get jackfruit at Tesco's. So we need, we're onto the garam masala now. Oh no, did I do the cumin? I did the cumin, but I only did 1 teaspoon of cumin, that's fine. Right, and I need 2 teaspoons of garam masala. I'm going to be using 4 because I'll use three because I'm using about half as much again because I've got that tofu that I've added. Come on, come out of there. Oh, I'm fixing to get a surprise amount. Whoop. One more. Bit more. That'll do. And then 3 teaspoons of turmeric. I'll be using 3, sorry. You guys need 2 if you're sticking to the regular old recipe. Yeah, I buy my jackfruit tins. I don't know if you can buy it fresh. I think it's possibly an Asian, where it possibly can. Oh no, product of Thailand. There you go. But that's what ours looks like. Young green jackfruit. Just give this pan a wee stir because I don't want anything to stick here, and I think we could be getting to a sticking stage if I'm not careful. Add a little bit more water to this, I think. Yeah, health food shops, specialty vegan or vegetarian shops. Certainly places that you're likely to find jackfruit if you can't get it at your regular supermarket. But Tesco's or Sainsbury's in the UK, I would think that, is that Abco's we used to go to in the States, hubby? Or some Safeway? Was it Safeway? Huge supermarkets that we used to go to, and I would be very surprised if they didn't carry it also. Okay, and I need 3 teaspoons of turmeric. You guys need 2 teaspoons. Such a lovely colour this adds, as well as flavour. Trying not to melt my spoon. Oh, the smells in here right now, just gorgeous. Look at that. Let's scrape this spice off my spoon. Don't lose any of that lovely flavour. Again, I think I'll add some more water to that. I don't want it to stick. Now you can use oil in this when you're bringing it together, but I'm happy to use the oil. Happy to use the water. Get yourself a good pan. You shouldn't have too much of a problem with it sticking when you're using water. Oh, this is one that suits, I don't want to melt my spoon. This is another plastic spoon. This is silicone. It doesn't melt quite so easily. And I didn't want to measure my melt my lovely Tupperware spoons. But yeah, I see where you're coming from. Okay. I just want to get all that lovely flavor off of there. So I'm going to turn this heat down if I can figure out how to work my doodah, my induction. That smells absolutely gorgeous. I wish there was a smell sensor that we could put through to you guys. Right, so heat your saucepan, a little bit of water or oil at medium heat. Slice your onions, we've done that. Add them to the saucepan. Once they're starting to soften, add in all the spices and stir well, and add a little bit more water if it's sticking, or we're good to go now. So now we want to add some of the cashew cream that we made earlier. That opened up. And we want about, what does it say, 3 tablespoons? So I'll use a bit more than 3. If I aim for about 4.5 tablespoons. Stir that in. Oh, look how lovely and rich that looks. So this is all about the seasonings, this dish. Jackfruit itself is very neutral in flavor. I guess you could use it. It was certainly not sweet. It's just a bit like tofu. It's I don't want to say tasteless either, but it picks up the flavor of whatever you put it into. So you have to make sure you add plenty of flavor to it. All right, that's starting to look very, very nice. So now we get ready to add our jackfruit and our tofu. So you know, jackfruit and tofu, neither of which need any further cooking, so we just need them really to heat through. All of that out of the bowl. So you see this shredded texture here, this is the jackfruit. So it's very, very similar texture to chicken, which is why it's very, very popular when you're cooking vegan meals, especially for newly transitioning vegans as well, that miss that texture of meat. But we've got the tofu in there also, so we've got some very good sources of protein. I was very worried about starting our son on a vegan diet, that he might be lacking in some essential nutrients. So I took him off to his GP for another appointment for something else, and whilst we were there just requested could we do some blood work just to make sure we're not missing out on any nutrients under this new diet. And the GP was very happy to oblige, and all of his blood work's come back absolutely top notch, so he's certainly not missing out on anything. Curry, the national dish of the UK. Yeah, you can't beat a good curry, can you? I haven't put these tomatoes in. When are they supposed to go? Stir one of that. Jackfruit mix. Lastly, add the tinned tomatoes. There you go. And about 1/2 cup of water to mix it in. So, 1 tin of tomatoes. So these are basil tomatoes, just because that's what I had inside my pantry. Drop that into there. And this is about 1/2 cup of water to mix. So what I'm going to do is put some water directly into my can and stir that around, get all the flavors off the edges. So all that flavor that you'd miss if you just dump the tomatoes out, scrape that all into the water, stir it all in together. You've bought it, you might as well get the use out of it. Please make sure you're recycling everything that you possibly can when you're doing your cooking. So it's wonderful to have these convenience foods and convenience canning and everything else, but we've got to do our best to look after our wee planet, as I've mentioned before. So that flavour that's coming out in that water that I've poured into the can, look at that, more yumminess. rinse that up for recycling. So we have a recycling truck that comes around once a week, and a rubbish truck as well. And this pokey little bin that they give us to recycle our paper and our plastics and our glass, all our recyclable materials, doesn't have a lid. So we live in quite a windy part of New Zealand. So guess what happens to all the rubbish that goes inside these bins? I've got smart, I lay a plank of wood on top of mine to keep the recycling rubbish inside the bins, but on a windy day, I'm glad I'm not the house that's at the very end of the street, because it's usually a wind that comes through from the west, blows it through to the east, and it ends up in his front lawn. Poor chap. Right, so we're just letting that heat through now. Pretty much everything that we want is inside this mix. As I mentioned earlier, if you're cooking rice from scratch, you should have put that on at the beginning of this recipe. Yes, you can do this curry with chicken, not a problem. You can put whatever you want inside your curry. We're just doing a vegan version, hence why I'm using the jackfruit and the tofu. So what was that thing in her hand? Which thing? This thing? That is my stirring spoon. What else would I have had in my hand? This thing. Oh, this thing. That's my can opener. Right, now I have this inside my pantry. It's basmati rice. You can cook it inside your microwave or you can sling it straight into your pan. So once again, whoops, I just want to get this used up. So I'm just going to dump it into the pan. I could have cooked this separately. It's just gone on my floor behind me. But I like cooking my rice in with the dish. Then it all gets coated beautifully and evenly in that lovely sauce. So I've got some rice that's stuck inside the bag here. Scrape that out. Every last little grain cometh hither. So yeah, you can easily make this a regular old carny board dish. Stick whatever meat you fancy. Prawns would be nice in here. Nice fish curry, some nice monkfish. You know, something with a bit of a bite to it. That would be yum. Now, where did that rice go that landed on the floor? Don't know. Right, sure the cats will find it later. So this is just about ready to serve. So a fluffy cheeseburger is around. You want to, carnivore, sorry. I shouldn't say carny. So a fluffy cheeseburger, if you're about, if you meander your way into the kitchen. Yes, I will crank the heat up a little bit. I just want to break this rice down because I forgot to squeeze the rice inside the packet before I opened it. So it wasn't very loose. Right. Heat, crank up. We'll get this little monkey simmering. Right, now I've got lots of cashew cream left here, and it says to serve this with, the, you know, on a bed of rice. With the jackfruit mixture on top, jackfruit and onion and spicy sauce mixture on top of it. And then a dollop of the cashew cream on top of that. Now I've got more than a dollop worth of cashew cream because I did make much more than I needed to. So I'm gonna stick a little bit more into this sauce. Oh, you heard me then?
Yeah.
Have you come for the feeding frenzy?
Summoned me.
You've been summoned. Would you like to stir this in?
Is this the nut cream?
Yes, Curtis, it's the nut cream.
Hey!
Right, don't slop it over the edges, please. I'm the only one allowed to make a mess here. Yes, yeah, so the rice that I added was pre-cooked rice in the bag. I hadn't microwaved it as it said on the recipe, but it will cook in the pot as we've got this heat running through it now. Imsaj, thank you very much. You always have to take it down to a new level, don't you?
That's green.
We've got Curtis joining in with you.
Father like son.
So Imsaj is my poor husband, who is also a streamer. He sings and plays guitar. He's got lots of his own original stuff. So please, if you're not already one of his followers, then please add him to your list and check in with him the next time he's live streaming. I'm sure you'll enjoy what he has to offer. Fluffy Cheeseburger is my techno geek. Correct? Is that correct?
Correct, yeah.
Techno geek. He's my nerd who does all of my IT stuff. And sorts me out when I'm doing things very, very wrong, and I run through to him in a mild panic, wild panic. He'll get things straightened out for me, so thank you for doing that. And Fluffy Cheeseburger also occasionally live streams video gaming, which...
And music.
Oh, that's right, because he's learned to play the bass guitar, and he's doing very, very well. I'm very impressed. Oh yeah, VR, what's that? Virtual reality, so... Beat Saber. Oh my gosh, if you've not tried Beat Saber and you've got a mate that's got a VR kit that can do Beat Saber, you got to go, like, take him a jackfruit curry and say, hey mate, let's set up this VR for a wee while and have a play. It's so much fun. Right, we are about ready now. Are you playing with my mic? We're about ready to eat. Are you hungry, Curtis?
I could eat.
You could eat? Should we get a couple of... bowls out and we'll have a wee taste. This is dinner tonight. Let's turn off this extractor fan. I don't think that needs to be on anymore. The smell of this is just wonderful. Oh, hi Eskimo brother, thank you for joining us here. The recipe is online. Please do give it a go. I'm going to turn the heat down on this a little bit. It's starting to catch on the bottom there, which is not a good thing. That's got that sorted. Turn it down one more. Yeah, please have a go at the recipe. The recipe is on my homepage. It's also popped up in the stream. There you go, Nightbot has just popped it up again. I've added tofu to the recipe also, and I've made 50% more of my cashew nut cream sauce to go with it. Just because I was adding extra onion because of the tofu and I just wanted plenty of flavour to go around. I've got some microwave basmati rice, which I didn't microwave. I just literally dumped it out of the packet into the pan and let it cook through. If you don't have any of that at home, then by all means, just use regular rice. Basmati is the best. If you can get that for this recipe, that's good. But any old rice that you have in your pantry will do the trick. So, do you want to have a... Oh, hang on a minute. We were about to have our feeding frenzy, but let me just see if I can get a sound effect for you. What was it you wanted, Pants? Oh, really? Is it your tea time? Yes? Do you want to eat? So, Sun was about to join me for a feeding frenzy here, but we've been interrupted by Cat. See if we can get Cat on stream. Pants, come over here. Look. Wow. There you go. That's Pants. We keep expecting him to not come home. He's old. He's lost a lot of weight. Please keep him well away from the food. He's old. He's lost weight. He's only got a couple of teeth left in his mouth. But he's hanging in there. Yep, he's otherwise known as the old bugger. Among other names that begin with B, especially when he's vomited, which you're not doing anymore, are you, Pants? You're a good boy. Do you want to get him fed so we can get fed, please?
Climbing the wall.
So he gets spoilt now because he keeps losing weight no matter what we do. We can't get
growing
him to yeah, he's growing something that's none too favorable, we feel. He's been off to the vets and the vets checked him over for several different things, and all we're left is one very negative thing, but he seems to be happy. He's not in any pain. He doesn't shut up. He eats about 73 times a day. So yeah, he's hanging in there. Right, Pants. Right, let him have that so we can have ours, please. Whenever he comes through and yells at as he gets fed, so we're just trying to get him to gain some weight. So he used to be an almost 5 kg cat and now he's down to 3.6. He was down to 3.3. Let's hear you yell. Yes? Yeah? What do you want? Uh-huh. When do you want it? Now? Are you going to come in here? Are you going to sit down? All right, sit down. Now you can have your tea. Good boy. Right, that's that sorted. Now we can get on with our eating our food. Right, how hungry are you, Curtis?
Starving.
Starving? Do I never feed you? Is that the problem?
He doesn't feed me.
Do you want a spoon or a fork?
I think it's a spoony one, isn't it?
I like spoon because then you can get the creaminess off the bottom. Right. I want to tilt that camera down. Is that enough for you? More?
Yes.
Will you eat more? Yeah. I don't want to put it in your bowl if I'm not going to
eat it.
So I might get a 10 then.
Maybe.
Is that enough for you?
That's good.
Do you need more?
No.
I want to
no,
get a 10.
Good, yeah.
Can I get a 10?
A 10 is an eggs benedict, perfectly crispy bacon.
But that's not vegan.
Saucy.
Right, you hold
sauce.
That. Wait. Bear with. Please hold the line, your call is important to us.
That juice.
Right, let everybody have a look at that. What do you reckon? So yes, thanks for joining us, Eskimo brother. Yes, I'm from England. We're a little bit of a hodgepodge of a family here. Kids were born in the States, husband's American, lived all over the place. I think a little bit more tofu in that one for me, because I like tofu. I'll turn this off. I'm very pleased at how well this induction hob's worked. Can I have some of this on top as well? Have you tasted it yet?
Not a fan of the nut juice.
You're not a fan.
But it might be good in the dish.
Do you think it needs some salt and pepper?
Yeah, it might. I haven't tasted the rest yet.
Oh, you haven't tasted it. Well, I don't think you're supposed to taste this on its own. Well, I like the juice. So we haven't put any salt and pepper.
Yeah,
it
definitely needs a bit of salt and pepper.
Needs salt and pepper?
Definitely
okay.
Salt, yeah. Pepper?
I haven't tasted it yet, so let me have a wee taste first. Need salt.
Yeah.
Doesn't need pepper. Definitely a salt thing. Whoopsie. There she goes. A little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper on yours as well. So definitely, there's no corn whatsoever in there. Is there season to taste at all? Which is unusual, you'd see that in a recipe. Give a good stir through, mix in that lovely cream sauce. Now Curtis, last time I didn't put tofu in this and you complained there wasn't enough texture. Is it better with texture?
Definitely.
Oh man. Mm. The onion isn't quite cooked all the way through, but it's actually good because it gives it
a crunch.
And that's very, very good. And the tofu?
Yeah, I love the tofu.
Hmm. Everything always needs salt. No, it doesn't. You should always taste your food before you add salt to it. Doesn't it drive me nuts when you go to a nice restaurant and your meal is served up in front of you and the first thing the person with you do is pick up the salt and pepper and drown it. Like you haven't even tasted it. How do you know that they've not put too much salt in the potatoes and now you're gonna oversalt them? Taste your first before you add more seasonings, peeps. Curtis, let's have a score. Can you stop licking the edge of your bowl?
It was dirty. So now it's dirty. Plate clean.
tidy edges.
Yeah.
So now you've added the salt and the pepper. So you've got the flavours there that you wanted to add into it. What's the score that you give this?
Got a solid 8.
8?
8.
You ate it?
I ate it.
Is it better with the tofu than when we did it without
Definitely
the tofu?
Definitely way better with the tofu.
With the tofu. But you need the jackfruit there as well.
Yeah. I think the tofu gives you something to chew on. Well, before it was kind of just... The jackfruit didn't really give it much of a texture. It was just kind of like stringy in the background.
Right.
But the tofu actually gives you something to eat, gnaw on.
This is really, really nice. So, everybody, thank you so much for joining me on my stream. It's been lovely to have you on board. Once again, that was a vegan jackfruit curry recipe. This does freeze beautifully, so you've got leftovers. That's what's going to be happening here. I'm going to be going away for a few days, and this is what's going to be going into the freezer for Santa. Serve himself up a nice meal.
Mm-hmm.
So, as you would for a regular recipe, I've got some small glass dishes. Dollop of your jackfruit inside, put some of the sauce on top, straight into the freezer once it's cooled. Make sure you date and label it. Use it up within 3 to 6 months. I've really enjoyed streaming with you guys. Thank you so much, MSarge510, for this wonderful mic. It's so much nicer than having to deal with that awful headset that used to slide off my head all the time. But thank you to Fluffy Cheeseburger for loaning that to me for the duration of my earlier streams.
It's all good. You know the torture now.
So I expect I'll probably be doing another stream at some point over the weekend so I can hit that 7 out of 7 that I need to hit. At the moment, I'm sitting at 6 out of 7 because the first stream was under his account, so it didn't count for me. And I'll see what I can come up with for you guys. Probably something vegetarian. We've ordered the My Food Bag, a vegetarian food bag, which is due to be delivered tomorrow at some point. And so I'll probably dig through that and see if there's something that I can bring up for you guys. So yes, please, Idrakini, is that right?
I drank
Genie.
Stand by.
Oh.
Their name before. Oh no, Eskimo is JD.
Okay. So thank you. I'm glad I've got you inspired. Please have a go at this recipe. If you can find jackfruit, if you can't find it on your supermarket shelves, ask for it. It might be hidden in some indiscreet or discreet place that you don't normally go into where there's cobwebs and stuff. So please, find jackfruit. It's worth having into your curry. If you can't get your jackfruit, go ahead, just throw in tofu, firm tofu. Or if you want to make this carnivore recipe, go ahead. Prawns would be really nice. Fish would be really nice. Chicken would be really nice. Pork, I don't know about beef. I don't know if the beef would go well with a creamy sauce, but there you go. I really enjoyed having you guys with me here today. I'm going to have a little wee search through and see if there's somebody that I can raid. If you guys can hang around whilst I get something sorted out onto my computer stream, then we'll see if we can raid somebody else that's out there doing some wonderful cooking recipes. So Miss Molly is on. So Curtis, can you show me how to do that raid thing once again?
So Dad's already followed them for you.
Okay, so thank you, hubby, for following them, and we're getting ready for a raid here. So thanks everybody for joining us, and let's pass you on to Miss Molly Makes. Bye.
Thank you so much for the raid. Welcome in. Welcome in, raiders. Watch, I'll get last place. Then I'll have to... Welcome in, Raiders. Hope you're having a great day. Purple Mumble Raid, thank you for the raid. How was your stream? We are doing a challenge here today. I've been given 5 ingredients. We are cooking with Madame Gandalf. Check out her channel as well. We're multi